Hello and welcome to another video about GammaRay. My name is Giuseppe D'Angelo, I work for KDAB. In this video, we'll start to delve more into GammaRay's features. Namely, we will start discussing the QtQuick inspector. The topic of today is how to debug our QtQuick interfaces. As you can imagine, debugging QtQuick is kind of a challenge, kind of a tricky topic, because QtQuick is mostly written using QML, which is a declarative language. And being a declarative language, it's a bit different than traditional imperative styles. It's hard to detect when something goes wrong, exactly what went wrong and why. So the example I'm going to show you today comes from my personal experience. One of the most common things that you can see in QtQuick is you create a typical user interface and one of the elements is simply not visible. And you have to understand why. There are many, many reasons why this could happen in QtQuick. One reason is, for instance, that the item size is accidentally 0x0. Another reason could be that the item is clipped by one of its ancestors. Yet another reason is that the item accidentally fell behind an item which is completely opaque, and so you don't see the one you're interested at. And finally, the item could be simply out of bounds, right? It could be outside the visible area of your application. So the item is there, but you cannot see it. So let me demonstrate this with a little bit of code, with a little example that I'm going to build for you. The example I'm going to build looks like this. So please take note of my amazing drawing skills. What I'm going to build is a very simple QtQuick application. It's going to display a small rectangle. And within this rectangle, I'm going to have a text on the left displaying a contact name and an image on the right displaying that contact avatar. Think of these as the building block of something more complex. For instance, a list of contacts, right? That you may have in a list view or something like that. So I'm going to build exactly this inside QtQuick, and I'm going to introduce a bug, of course, and we see how GammaRay helps us debugging this kind of code. Here it is. We have some code here in front of us. This code implements exactly what I wrote on my piece of paper. What I have on the top here is a rectangle, and this is very simple. It's a light blue rectangle that will hold everything together. Down here, I got a text element. The text says Mary. That's the name of our contact. And as I said, I want this text to appear on the left of the rectangle. So what I have here is a little bit of anchoring saying that the text should be vertically centered within the rectangle and also aligned to the left, of course. Down here, I got an image element. This is going to be our avatar. So our image is loaded from this file that I have on disk. And as I said, I want the image to appear on the right of the rectangle. So also for the image, I'm going to set some anchoring. I'm going to put the image to be vertically centered into its own parent, right here. And also say that the left of the image should anchor to the right of the parent. That is exactly what I want, right? Maybe not. Let's see the example in action and see what's going wrong here. So here it is. I'm running the example. And as you can see, I can clearly see the blue rectangle. I can clearly see the text, but I don't see the image at all. So the question for you now is that what is going wrong and how do you fix, how do you find out in the first place? It's not so easy, right? In QML, again, as I said, there are many, many ways that things can go wrong from a visual point of view. And that's exactly where a tool like GammaRay can help you and actually will help you detecting exactly what's wrong in this example and how to fix it. So let me launch GammaRay, and then we see together how to improve this example and how to find a bug. In order to launch GammaRay, what I'm going to do is to use this shortcut they have installed inside Qt Creator. You can watch the previous video of mine to know how to install such a shortcut. So I'm going here right here in the tools, external, KDAB, GammaRay, and this will launch GammaRay. And I'm going to tell GammaRay to attach to my running example. Okay, now this is done. And what we see in here is the QtQuick scenes module of GammaRay. GammaRay comes with many, many modules. Of course, depending on what area you're interested in, you have to select one given module. This is, of course, QtQuick debugging, so I'm going to select the QtQuick module for this. And inside this module, what we're going to see is that I've got on the top left here the structure of my scene. So indeed, it matches what I've just built. I've got a rectangle, and inside this rectangle, I've got my image and my text. Everything sounds normal. Down here, I've got a live preview of my QtQuick application, okay? So indeed, this is what I'm seeing on the screen. Let me switch to the actual application, which is running over there. And this is showing exactly the same. It's showing that I only see the text. I don't see the image. And that's obviously a problem. So what I can do here to debug this problem, I can click here on the image in the tree, right? So clicking, selecting one element will tell me a few things. The first thing it tells me is that on the right, I start seeing all the properties for that particular element. I see all the properties, actually all the methods, all the signal slot connections, and much, much more. GammaRay is able to visualize all this information for us so that we can quickly check what is the status of this image. For instance, what is its size? I can quickly go in here and see that both the width and height are 64, meaning the image is not 0x0, the image is there, right? I didn't do that mistake. I made another mistake. So what else could be going wrong? Maybe the image is not loaded correctly. I can check the status property down here, but the status says ready. So the image was loaded correctly, right? Eventually, I come up to the one which is, of course, wrong. If I visualize the position of the image, which is neatly displayed in this visualization on the bottom left part inside GammaRay, you can see that the image has been placed wrong. What do I mean by that? The image has been placed outside the visible area of our application. Indeed, the anchoring that I made was slightly wrong. The image has been anchored right to left, and that's not exactly the anchoring I wanted, right? What I really wanted was actually anchoring the right part of the image to the right part of the background. So GammaRay allowed me to actually visualize this. You can clearly see that the image is outside the boundaries. And by clearly visualizing it, now I can immediately spot the mistake and how to fix it. This mistake is so common that actually GammaRay has a specific warning for it. The warning is visualized in the top left panel here. You may see that the image has a small exclamation mark next to it. And if I hover that exclamation mark, this will tell me the item is visible, but is outside the view. So I figured it out. Now I can close GammaRay, go back into the code and fix the problem. So the problem was this anchoring that I had right here. All I need to do is fix the anchoring. Launch application again, and now I do see both the contact name and the avatar. So obviously this is just scratching the surface. There is so much more to be said. I'm going to introduce all the various tools that GammaRay comes with in the following videos, but that's all I have for you today in this video. So thank you very much for listening. See you next time.